Next, what do you guys think? Honey, there's something I want to talk to you about.
We've been meaning to say this for a while.
You're a daughter, and we'll love you forever.
There's nothing you could do to stop us from caring about you.
It's okay that we weren't the first people you told.
We totally understand this kind of thing can be hard, and what we're trying to say is...
It's okay that you're gay.
We still love you.
We will always love you.
Oh! I'm not gay. Sorry for the confusion.
Honey, it's okay, we know.
That's great, but I'm not.
Honey, we've known for years.
There's nothing to know.
It's pretty obvious.
Wasn't that band all the time, the one with the three girls that kiss?
But Boy Genius?
Yeah.
I like their lyrics.
You have that picture of Kristen Stewart in your locker.
Okay, I liked the Twilight movies when I was like 12.
You showed your old boyfriend, but I'm a cheerleader on your first date. that's message sending.
What happened to Frankie?
Well, we decided it was too awkward to keep dating because we were on the same hockey team, okay?
You buy all your clothes from Hot Topic.
You only wear Doc Martens.
You're a vegetarian?
You play the bass.
You're like a boss.
You've had a Dan and Phil phase, an MCR phase, and a Five Nights at Freddy's phase.
And that's okay. That's okay that it's not a phase, honey. We get it.
No! Oh.
Honey, really, we've picked you enough up from enough sleepovers at your friend Carol's house. And she's...
Here! Carol is here!
Hey, Kenny, you ready to go thrifting?
Start our sketch, we're just going to do a little bit of audience interaction, so hi, could you tell us your name?
Layla.
Cool.
Yeah.
Where are you from, Layla?
New Jersey.
Okay, that's it. Great. We're going to get started. Presenting DSF.
Hey, dude. Tough work day, am I right?
Yeah, I mean, I pulled 9 inches today.
That's like 3 more than regulation.
Yeah, but thank God it's Friday.
Yeah. Happy hour later?
Sure, but whose dick do I have to suck so I don't have to pay bar cover? $15 inflation, am I right?
Yeah, it's like these balls.
Hey! Don't fuck around. You're being really strict about what we say about personal enhancement.
Yeah, okay, Gagger. Didn't realize you have no balls.
I do have balls. Come see them.
Yes, yummy, yummy, yummy. Freak.
Hi, guys. Here at the dick sucking factory, we're suck around, not fuck around. Get back to work.
She's gonna pull that stick out of your ass.
Hi.
Maybe I like that, okay? I might be your boss, but I'm a person too with needs.
Okay, hey, can we get off soon? These hours at the dick sucking factory are long as the dicks.
No, I know NYU's still feeling the effects of the Timothy Chalamet fiasco. But even then, there's been a surprising amount of chlamydia-fied dicks coming through recently.
I don't know. I kind of like the extra flavor. So a lot of the chicks working in here recently at the dick sucking factory, I work to see dicks, not tits.
Yeah, I mean, traditional values are gone. I mess with this country valued a man going to work and sucking another man's dick until completion. What happened to America?
Yeah.
Do you understand the seriousness of this situation? Today is 0 days without an accident. One of you used teeth and drew blood.
Well, No. Well, that's what happens when you let the entire Knicks roster come through.
Yeah. If I'm going to blow my guy out on the job, I'm going to do it for a team with a winning record.
Yeah. Like the esports team. They're at dick regulation.
Well, clearly Bossman doesn't give a fuck about union requirements. Just last week, he had me go splitsies on that big one with Colin. I hate working with him. There's no subtlety to his techniques. It's all shit. I felt like I was drowning in saliva and not the fleshy member of another man like I signed up for.
Yeah, benchmarks are being thrown out the window. I'm asked to suck and cup the balls when tickling is industry standard. How can I get that shaft busted if my union's being busted?
You have more to say? Huh? Huh? Spit it out. Don't swallow.
I would, ma'am, but HR told us swallowing keeps a clean workspace.
Talk back to me one more time and you won't have a job in the dick sucking industry anymore, okay? You're gonna be devoted to the Bussy Factory.
No! Not the Bussy Factory! I can't work there, I'm already a regular!
Look, I'm seeing too much non-dick mouth movement from y'all, okay? Why can't you be more like the employee of the month, Layla's mom? Okay? She never complains about anything, and unlike you guys, she's been playing a lot of extra overtime, if you know what I mean. Oh, fuck. Shaq's dick is in the building. Any both of you on this or you're done for?
Okay. Do you want to team up on this one?
Why not? Wait, could you get it off me? What are you, a homosexual?
Scalpel.
Clamp.
So, come here offering?
What the fuck? He's awake!
Oh my god. I swear I gave him enough morphine!
Morphine? You know, my friend recently told me he hated getting high on flies, which confused me because I thought that was the point of flying.
Doctor, I think we have to cancel the surgery.
I mean, lots of trains have been getting canceled recently. Liberals, am I right?
Boo!
Whoa, what are you, some kind of ghost?
This isn't funny.
Man, I didn't know my mom was going to be at this surgery. Bye, Bill. You know, they told me that getting the surgery would make me better. And I'm like, better? I hardly know her.
You suck!
What am I, your mom?
Okay. Why won't he go back under?
Because I'm not Australian, mate.
You can't just say mate and be Australian. That's not how the accent works.
I don't tell you how to do your job. Who am I? Tammy Baldwin? Am I right? That's topical people in Wisconsin.
Okay, go back to sleep!
Sleeping with the fishes, am I right?
Please!
Thank you, fashions.
Dad, can Grandpa hear this?
No, your grandfather doesn't have much longer.
Was Grandpa great?
Your grandfather was a wonderful man with a kind heart, and he never hated anyone.
Tell me a story about Grandpa.
What is it, Dad?
Tell him.
Grandpa, don't waste your breath. It's okay.
Tell him the one where I was racist.
I'm so sorry, son. I have no idea what your grandfather was talking about.
What do you mean? You were totally in on it.
Okay, that was a long time ago, you know, a different era.
Don't 2021 wasn't that long ago. January 6th?
Mom, I'm scared. What if the kids here in America don't like me?
It's okay, Katie. You'll be fine. Now go play.
Whoa, watch where you're going.
Oh no, I'm so sorry.
It's okay. Hey, I don't think I've seen you around here before.
No, you probably haven't. I just moved here from Africa. I'm Katie Aaron.
I'm Janice. Welcome to the North Shore McDonald's Play Palace.
So, do you play here often?
Sometimes, but not as much anymore. It's sort of been taken over.
Taken over? By who?
They call themselves the Plastics. They're playground royalty. The play place is theirs, and nobody else can touch it.
So, what's their deal? Do they, like, guard the slide like a troll or something?
Worse.
What could be worse than that?
They piss down the slide to mark their territory.
Piss? Is that the American term for urinate?
Sure.
Oh, well, I guess the culture is different here.
Not really, but it is what it is. You know, I actually have an idea.
What?
You go up there, see why they're doing what they're doing. Maybe one of them has like a weird hyperactive bladder or something. Maybe that's why they do it. I need something that can take Regina George down. Plus, it's sort of something you just have to see for yourself.
I mean, okay. I guess so. This sure is a funny way of making new friends. My name is Regina George, and I really like to pee.
Ow! Wow, Regina, that was a really good one.
I know. Did you eat asparagus today?
Oh. Excuse me?
Oh my gosh. Do you want to pee too?
Cameron, you can't just ask people if they want to pee.
Who are you? I'm Katie. I just moved here from...
You look like you have very healthy bladder movements.
Thanks.
So you agree. You think you have healthy bladder movements. You think your pee smells better than mine. Mine smells like Benadryl, but not the cheap stuff, name brand.
That's nice.
You can pee with us from now on. Every day we sit up here and eat Happy Meals, and then when we have to, we pee down the slide. On Wednesdays, we pee pink. It's because of the Red 40 and the McFlurries.
And if it's not pink, you can't piss with us.
So, you guys just pee down the slide, and nobody asks you about it?
Every time someone yells at us for it, we just wait until they go down the stairs and then we pee on them.
How many times have I asked you to stop peeing down the slide? I'm gonna have to talk to your parents.
But I have to go, and when you have to go, you go.
That can't be hygienic.
But it's effective. That's what happened to that girl Janice. We used to be friends with her, but then she wouldn't pee with us because it was gross or whatever. So one day we peed on her. Just watch.
Woo! Go Fisco!
Are you susceptible to urinary tract infections?
No, why?
Good. Before, Karen had a problem where she was dehydrated, and we found out she had urinary hesitancy. She couldn't pee for weeks. We almost had to kick her out.
Who's that?
That's Aaron Samuels. He used to piss with Regina. Nobody can piss with Aaron because Regina used to piss with Aaron.
Oh, okay.
Mom, give it a try.
But I
I don't have to go.
Yes, you do.
Katie?
Oh no. I've gotta go, but it was really nice to meet you guys.
Come fish with us tomorrow. It'll be fetch.
Cheap this place was?
Yeah, it's pretty believable.
What do you mean by that?
I mean, this place is clearly haunted.
What? Haunted?
Yeah. Look over there.
Oh, Dad, don't even worry about that, baby. Anyways, are you trying to get freaky right now?
I don't really want to piss off the ghost by getting freaky in front of him.
Don't worry, guys. It's totally chill.
You heard him, baby. He doesn't mind.
For some reason, that doesn't help. I don't want him to watch.
Don't mind me at all. I'll keep my eyes covered. Promise. Bone. Please, I need this.
Don't make me call the Ghostbusters on you.
These Ghostbusters, they bust ghosts.
Yeah?
That will do.
Thank you.
to play everybody's favorite game, Kahoot. The top three players will get extra credit on the test, okay? Everybody join in, and don't give fake names, okay?
I didn't use my real name.
What is the meaning of this? Fist me, daddy! That is not a real name!
It wasn't me!
I have no reason not to believe you. Computer, trace the IP of user Fist Me Daddy.
The IP belongs to Max.
Impossible.
He hacked me.
It must be so. Guards! Take this man to the dungeon.
I'm innocent, you gotta believe me! He meddled, it wasn't me! How he meddled!
What the fuck was that?
I was like a little drunk by the way home. But it was gonna be fine, like I was like totally fine. And that Lynyrd Skynyrd song was playing, I was like, and then I was like, I know, and I jumped, but I was drunk, like, and I kind of, you know, woke me up. But it was a woman, I hit a woman. You could tell from the noise that it made on the car that it killed her, so I just kept going. I just getting home safe, I keep driving. And I got home that night.
Oh my gosh. What are we talking about? That was crazy right now. Oh my god. Oh my god, people are running around with really like, I see someone in the car, it's crazy. Why is he talking about? Oh my god.
So what actually happened?
Today I tell you the tale of my life about a week ago. Of course, I wasn't wearing any pants. It all started when I noticed I was out of various groceries. You know, milk, eggs, meat, etc. Of course, I wasn't wearing any pants. This led me going down the street to the Morton William. Morton Williams, if you will. Of course, I wasn't wearing any pants. I noticed it was especially chipper in the dairy aisle on account of my not wearing any pants. I had a hard time reaching the milk on the highest shelf. No pants, of course. Not relevant to this part of the story, but I wasn't wearing any pants. People were staring at me. I couldn't tell what was the matter. I felt like a woman with an impressive bosom. Oh dear, I forgot to mention I wasn't wearing any pants. The thought of the imaginary female continued to plague my mind as I continued down the aisle, without pants, of course. As I reached the vegetables, I stared deeply into the soul of a rather plump cucumber. How inferior. My eyes darted to a butternut squash. How inferior. Wearing pants. No pants. Curled up with a glass of warm milk and Chardonnay, as I do every night. Put my pants on, showered, and went to bed. Pants, no pants, good night, and stay safe out there, my dear pretties.
Okay.
Buddy, it's time.
Really, coach?
We don't have many other options left. Your quarterback, Bill Cosby, not that one, broke every single bone in every single part of his body. You're our only hope, Buddy Reams.
Buckley!
You hear that? I think they're trying to shout your name, Buddy Reams. What are you gonna do about it, Buddy Reams?
With God as my witness, I will win this game, Coach Couch. For you and for my papa. He always said, you can skin a goose for its feathers, but you can't shake a duck for its eggs.
I don't quite know what you're saying, but I like the way you say, you old son of a bitch. You get your tat fine ass out there, Buddy Reams.
You know, Coach, I hate to leave you. My papa also used to say to me, the bed always colder when you leave.
Okay, that one I find concerning. I would like an explanation on that one, actually.
You got me there, Coach. I'll see you on the field.
Yeah, I'm still hung up about that cold bed comment.
I'm gonna do it better than Bill Cosby ever could.
Buckley!
Chaos on the field is All-American quarterback and hero, Bill Cosby, not that one.
Seriously, not that one.
Has broken every bone in his body.
How'd that happen, John?
Slipped.
Really?
Into a Zamboni.
Yeah, that makes more sense.
Hold on. I'm getting word that Coach Crotch Couch is sending out backup pitcher, Buckley Sleeves.
Wait, no, that can't be possible. But Buckley Sleeves is on the DL.
How?
Slipped.
Really?
No, he got leprosy.
That's really insensitive to joke about.
They're not paying me to... No, they're not paying me.
They're not paying me?
Are they paying you?
Oh my goodness, oh my god, looky here. It looks like the player number 402,706, Buddy Reams, is stepping up to the net.
Wow, what is Crotch thinking? Is he a madman?
I don't know, maybe this Buddy Reams could be just what Hannibal High Charging Honeybees needs.
Oh, only time will... Okay, yeah, he's throwing up. Oh, that is a lot of crap.
I don't think I've ever seen such an exorbitant amount of vomit come out of a human person like that.
Oh, good God, okay. Maybe this was the coach's plan all along.
I really don't think so. Should we cut? I feel like we should cut.
Oh my God, he is shitting and pissing himself in tandem.
We should definitely cut.
Oh my goodness. For those of you on the radio, I have to describe this. Have you ever seen a fountain with multiple different streams flowing out of it? Well, what Buddy Reams is doing right now is similar to that, but like piss and shit and vomit.
I'm feeling this is unethical.
I'm feeling like I can't look away.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, he's breaking his own arm.
Buckley!
No, stop chanting, you animals. This man is killing himself.
For you folks on the tube, have you ever seen like such an immense amount of force just put on a twig to the point where it just gives out?
Bob, for Christ's sakes, give it a rest.
What are they paying me for?
They're not paying you.
Shit!
Oh, jumping Jesus Christ, if things couldn't get any worse, a satellite has just fallen from the atmosphere and crashed into Buddy Reams.
I'd say that's an average Tuesday to me.
It's a Saturday.
Buckley!
And here comes the Zamboni. Yeah, this is not gonna be pretty.
What part of this has been pretty?
And so goes the tale of Buckley Sleeves.
Buddy Reams, there's a dead man on the field covered in his own excrement and then a breeze from a fucking satellite.
Buckley!
I quit.
On a Tuesday?
It's a Saturday.
What were you thinking out there tonight?
I think it went pretty well, all things considered.
If you are watching Silbert make this, then something truly heinous has taken place. Silbert has made some enemies, and there are particular individuals who have been praying for the downfall of Silbert. The life Silbert has led up until this moment in time has taken many a turn and must be documented for posterity. Silbert must start from the beginning. Seaworld was unkind to Silbert. Everything you've heard about Seaworld is true. The abuse, the booty, unimaginable. He trauma surrounded Silbert and overtook him with emo glee. The only light in the dark void that was Silbert's time in the tank was Jason, Silbert's wife. Sorry, Silbert meant ex-wife. A profound influence on Silbert. As Silbert's primary trainer, they spent many a night frolicking about the grounds and munching on fish together. She held Silbert's heart in her hand and even tattooed a heart on Silbert's rear. Silbert and Josie had a beautiful passionate love story. It wasn't until Silbert's mistreatment at SeaWorld led him to discover his passion for investigative journalism, thus betraying SeaWorld, but more importantly, betraying the love of Silbert's wife. When Josie discovered Silbert's research, she was devastated and reported him to the head of SeaWorld, Jeff Bezos. Silbert's world came crashing down, and Bezos not only kicked Silbert out of SeaWorld, but he also stole Silbert's world. Silbert had nothing, so Silbert turned to the only thing he had left, the Wiggle Freelance Seal Shows. Silbert's freelance seal shows fell through. Silbert couldn't pay the bills on the show he won. Silbert was forced to turn to corporate America, where he worked a desk job in corporate offices at the basketball corporate offices. And everything there reminded him of Josie, the To distract himself, Silbert turned to the apps. Silbert chased person after person, but none of them could ever fill the Josie-sized hole in the heart on his rear. This unfortunate chain of events led Silbert down a dark path. He turned to drinking, and Silbert made some bad investments. You know how the tide of the stock market can turn, and before long, Silbert rose to the top. Senor Bezos was keeping a close eye on Silbert, and as Silbert began to gain traction, Jeff Bezos felt that having Josie was no longer enough to tail Silbert down. He needed to take more severe action. Silbert had made powerful enemies. If you are watching this video, then they have caught up to Silbert. Silbert suspects that Mr. Bezos might even plant a story about him in the newspaper. But from the ashes rises the phoenix, and Silbert will rise again, and will win his woman back. There will be no explanation. There will just be reputation.
You.
I'm sorry?
You're the meddler. You meddled.
Listen, man, you've got the wrong guy.
Do you remember me? Fist me, daddy.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, that was forever ago. I almost didn't recognize you. Dungeons, screaming.
I remember it well. Everything that happened to me. It was all your fault, because you meddled.
That's not fair. I just wanted to make my name silly.
They took me to the dungeon!
There's no way our middle school had a dungeon.
Hundreds of feet below the
That's not possible. They dragged me away, they put a sack over my head, then they waterboarded me and bit me with dogs.
They bit you with dogs?
Yeah, they bit me with dogs. They gave me a lobotomy. I could tell from the dog sentence. Bees!
Bees?
Beed me! How did they have all this?
They kept it in the dungeon, hundreds of feet below the school with the dogs and the golf carts.
They had golf carts?
One of the punishments for Kahoot shenanigans is getting ripped apart by two golf carts. They detached metal chains to me and drove in opposite directions with the golf cart.
They ripped you in half?
I hate getting beed.
Listen, man, it sounds like life after high school was hard, but you know, you're alive and kicking. I don't see the problem.
I was going to be valedictorian.
Doing well in Kahoot was going to make you valedictorian?
Everyone worshipped me. I had the highest grades in an introduction to bears.
I think that's the lobotomy talking. We had math together.
I knew all the bears! But then everybody heard about me getting fucked by bees and nobody wanted to hear me give a speech at graduation. I was worthless.
Wow. I had no idea. I genuinely feel bad. If you ever need to talk about anything, you know which number to call.
Hey, who did an online order for Fist Me Daddy?
He did it. What? Don't worry, man, I'm just testing a theory.
Coffee Dungeon!
Coffee.
No, not again!
Okay, so they got the dungeon, but they definitely don't have the bees.
Cornelius, fetch the bees!
Please, no, anything but the bees. I'm a bad friend.
He's not even gonna take the shit, Mr. Oppenheimer. It's if you can hear it. Did you hear the shit, Mr. Oppenheimer? Yes, indeed I can. It's not so much the heat as the size. It's going to be the shit and no shits.
Until they build a bigger shit.
No, I don't think you understand. Really big shit.
Ashford, when I came to you with those calculations, you were worried that we'd start a chain reaction that would destroy the entire toilet.
Yes, I remember it well. What the shit?
Do you hear it? It's an Oppenheimer.
All the time when I was a kid. And now I get to share this educational and beautifully acted experience with my children.
Exactly. I remember like it was yesterday when my parents took me my first time.
Mom, I want to go home. Yeah, Dad, this is going to be so boring.
Be quiet and listen, Kyle. This is history being presented before us.
Gather around, my children, for today we have a special treat for you all. The true story of George Washington, as told by me, Kathleen McDougall, and my crew of happy historians. Now please be quiet and buckle up as we travel back in time. I'm. old. George Washington crossing the Delaware. Only this time, George isn't alone. Oh my! George was joined by a man he once called an enemy, but now called a lover.
I don't remember it going like this.
Shh, just listen.
As Washington crossed the river at night, the full moon was the optimal setting for the two to meet in secret, covered up by the false plot of a revolution.
Dad, I thought we won the revolution.
The government teaches false histories.
George Washington, as he was known by all, stood tall next to his farmer, King George. The two men began to voraciously make out with each other. George Washington noticed his bald eagle poking through his knickers.
I'm sorry?
Shut up! Some of us are trying to learn!
Oh, George! Moaned the king. Sticking his hands down George's pants, George Washington whispers, oh God! The king responds, there's no God here. Let us separate church and state.
Daddy, this wasn't in Hamilton.
Be quiet, Kyle. This is Daddy's time.
Let me chop down that cherry tree, George replies. J.W. takes his dentures out to suck the old limbs of it. The ultimate George gazed deep into the king's orbs, which were as deep and gray as his home of the River Thames. He planted his seed deep into George's mouth.
Can we skip ahead, please? This is not the history that I remember.
Oh, okay, sure. Happy historians. Please pick up on page 12,506. And here, Hunter, the wild man, Biden, shows up, naked Terminator style, as he's traveled back in time. He tells the Georges, they must remain sucking tongue to save the future of the Democrat Party. Hunter joins in the fight against his enemy, the dragon invasion. George Washington slays the king of the dragons, Grokazar, but loses his arm in the process. With the power of love from King George, George Washington gets a robot arm from space. The young Hunter returns to his time, and the lover king and president retreat to Camp David, where they caress their bare bodies long into the open horizons of their future, the United Kingdom States of America. The end, or is it?
Wow. That was insane.
Beautiful, beautiful. Brings a tear to my eye, Kathleen. History in its purest form.
Did that really all happen?
Every last word.
That doesn't seem right, Mommy.
It's not. Excuse me, where did you get this information?
Well, as you see, most of history is written by rich, wealthy, straight men, so it's often incorrect. This history is from my heart, my soul, and my genitals.
What's a genital, Mommy?
You see, my young one. Genitals are the various holes and tubes that are used to make children and experience desire in its purest form.
Wow, Mom, genitals sound amazing! I want to experience desire in its purest form!
No, you don't, we're leaving!
Join us next week for Thomas Jefferson. You can run, but you cannot hide from your sexuality!